Working with time in Excel can be tricky. Consider the difference between calculating the number of hours worked in a week or needing to figure out your arrival time after adding 45 minutes to your trip. So key to calculating time correctly is using the right time formatting. A common way of formatting time in Excel is by displaying it as a time in the day. And you can easily do this by typing the time that you want to display followed by AM or PM. So let's say you want to show 3 PM as the start time. You would just type 3 followed by the PM designation. Just be careful to always insert a space between the time you enter and AM or PM, because otherwise it will not work. A different way you can format your time is by highlighting your times and then in the number section of your home tab, selecting the time formatting. You'll also find more options to format the time of day. If you select the times you want to format, right-click and select Format Cells. And here, if you go to the time category, you'll see several options. Any of the options that show PM next to them or are displayed in military time, like this 1330, can be used to display time of day. But what if your AM or PM time format gets changed or erased? So it's important to know that Excel sees all time the same as a fraction of the day. The values range from 0 for 12 a.m. to 0.999 for 11:59 p.m., representing a portion of a 24-hour day. So for example, if you see a 0.50, that's the same as 50% of a 24-hour day or noon. So let's undo this and let's reformat this again so that it's not in military time. Now, what if you instead need to calculate the hours elapsed between the start time and the end time to help figure out the total hours? Well, to do this, we'll need different formatting because we now need to aggregate the time, and a format with AM or PM is just not going to make sense. So to do this, we will right-click again and select Format Cells. And from the time formatting, you can select the one that says 37:30:55. And just FYI, the option above it that says 30:55.2, that one doesn't display the hours. The 30 is actually starting with the minutes. Now, what if you instead want to show your number of hours elapsed as a regular number rather than hours, minutes, and seconds like we have here? Well, you can create your own custom time format. To do that, right-click again, go into Format Cells, and this time go into the custom category. So here you'll already find some time formats to choose from. They're the ones here with the H, 2Ms, and 2Ss, but you can also build your own. So say you want to show just the total hours that have elapsed. You can come to the type field box and inside brackets, type an H and click OK. So the brackets are key whenever you want to calculate elapsed hours. And let me show you why. If you were to type just an H without the brackets, it's now reflecting as a single digit just what would be an hour of a day. So we know that the total hours is not 2 hours, it was 26. So using the brackets ensures that Excel knows we're aggregating hours and not trying to display the hour of the day. Now, if you would like to add elapsed minutes to this, you would simply append this just by adding a colon and the minutes. And you can see up here in your sample box what that would look like. And likewise, if you want to also display seconds, just add the colon and 2 S's. Now, if you instead want to show your total elapsed time in minutes and not hours, it would be the 2 M's that you would want to include inside the brackets. For more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.